Hi everyone, and welcome to another trade analysis video here. The subject today, guys, is going to be Cable based on the Delta software. Basically, during the week I got, during the weekend, I got many questions regarding the Cable, so I've decided to create this video. Besides, we have a Delta pattern here, so it might be really interesting for you guys to check out my analysis. So the question is whether this thing is ready to go down. And in order to answer this question, in my opinion, we should first of all go ahead and ask ourselves in what time frame, in what timestamp, time ranges are we talking about? Is this long term? Is this mid term? Is this short term? Okay, this is the first thing that you need to define for yourself before you start going to make the analysis. That being said, let's go back just to the other template here for a second and start with the weekly chart. Okay, I'm not going to cover monthly because this is already too high, okay, in terms of time frames, and not very relevant for the majority of the retail traders, but weekly is good enough. So let's focus on this part, guys, right here. What does that tell us? For me, this is a bearish move, okay? This is a move that started creating lower lows and lower highs. Then we got divergences and an attempt to break above to create a convergence. Now, technically speaking, this is a convergence. But there are two very important factors that we need to mention here. First of all, the price never managed to gain the momentum, close above and so on, above this previous high here, which is the first important thing telling us, okay, there's probably an issue with that. Second part is the correction. Okay, this correction is way too deep, and I'm not saying it might not work. I'm just saying, if we're indeed going to have a reversal pattern, usually this is how it goes. Okay, there is momentum, the price is closing below the actual level or above it, and it just gains the momentum. Okay, we're not looking at such crazy deep pullbacks. So these two things are telling me that this is probably a false attempt to create the convergence and the reversal pattern, and we should be looking at this thing as a range, meaning bearish move, false break on the top, false break at the bottom. And there we go, we are inside a potential range now. That means I can go ahead and mark here our top and bottom zones to see where we stand. Okay, and as we can see, we need to focus on the bottom side because the price is currently here. We just arrived at that bottom, but we still have some room towards the extreme point here. Okay, so all that room is still relevant for us, maybe even breakout and continuation. Okay, we don't know yet. Important part is we still have room, and we basically have nothing against, okay, because this is a range still. The hidden divergence, the divergence traders are probably going to notice that, is here. But the question is that divergence confirmed on daily? Okay, and the answer for me is no, it's not. That means it's not relevant for me, at least not yet. Excuse me. So weekly covered, we know we are in a bearish mode, we know we are stuck in a ranging pattern, we are near the bottom, and we have a bit more room towards the extreme point, without any confirmations for bullish momentum upwards. That basically means bearish. Okay, bottom line, the summary in a word is bearish. Now let's go back to the Delta template, and what I wanted to show here is this one. Okay, so we technically speaking have a Delta pattern right here. All right, this is the scanner. It tells us we have a bearish Delta pattern on daily, that we can go ahead and combine aggressively with the 1 hour chart, conservatively with the 4 hour chart, and look for bearish setups to trade to the downside. Now going back to the chart, this is the daily chart, okay? Using the checklist, let's go through everything. By the way, this is a previous setup here with the convergence. Okay, so we can go ahead and remove this line so we don't get confused. This one made a good push downward, so I hope you made money, but let's focus on the current situation. Do we have divergence against? This is already the hard time frame, right? So hard time frame, divergence against. Do we have anything against us at the moment? No, we don't. We'll go ahead and say no. And right now the recommendation is going to change. Then do we have hidden divergence with us this time? And the question is, I'm not sure if you can see it well, but no, we don't. So nothing against in terms of convergences, but also nothing with us. So we put that again, X. Do we have levels around the current price? So let's go ahead and find this is the current price. So we start looking for levels. This is one level, which the price already more or less broke. We can leave it here, it's fine. Then, in my opinion, this is the next level we have. That zone, these guys here, okay? So, technically speaking, this is a good resistance zone. And then we move forward and check one or two more, like this. Okay, and we create the most recent levels around us, we plot them on the chart. And we can say, do we have a level? In my opinion, yes, we do, right? So now the recommendation is that we can look for entries, but this is with medium risk, okay? And so far, so good. Now let's continue to dig deeper and see what happens on the 4 hour chart this time, okay? On the 4 hour chart, we see that the price started giving us the pullback after this five leg structure. Okay, divergences and so on and so forth, and it managed to create a divergence with a false break. Now, in other words, if the price goes and breaks below that low, we already have a valid bearish setup that we can actually trade. Remember what was the recommendation? Medium. I am going to confirm that medium coming from the checklist with one more or two more arguments here. First of all, having this cycle or five leg structure impulsive move to the downside completed means that we want to see the price going slightly higher, meaning these zones here, 38 to 50. Now we can go ahead and argue that this was reached or not. That's 30 pips here, okay. Not that much, but it's also something that, in my opinion, we shouldn't be ignoring. Plus, we still don't have the breakout yet. And that's number one, basically meaning, based on the last 4 hour chart cycle, we can expect the price to go slightly higher. On the 1 hour chart, we have another confirmation in terms of possible bullish continuation to the upside because we started forming an impulsive wave. Okay, some might go ahead and read it like that. It would also be correct. In my opinion, we are still in here towards the 161.8 pullbacks and then one more continuation higher. So that means if we're currently inside leg number four, pardon, and we're going to see a range instead of ABCD, the price should be trading around this zone before we see one more push upwards. Okay? And again, we confirm that in the short term, we might be looking short to midterm at bullish moves. So, what's the bottom line here? Let's go ahead, go back actually, and answer the question, is cable going down? Weekly chart, in my opinion, yes, we still have some more room to the downside. So after these pullbacks, we're probably going to see continuation lower. Let's write this slightly better. Daily chart. What was the conclusion from the daily chart? We have a bearish we have a bearish delta setup, no divergences against us, but also no hidden divergence to put bearish pressure, okay, to the downside, which means the price is still inside this momentum, which is bullish. So daily, I would say neutral at the moment. And the 4-hour chart together with the 1-hour chart, in my opinion, are currently bullish. Yes, H4 has the bearish divergence, but it doesn't have the breakout. Okay, and since it doesn't have the breakout, a divergence for me means just a pullback. If we get through that zone and we get the breakout and the convergence, and we close below it, then this is going to be a possible first attempt for a sell, medium to aggressive setup, meaning using less risk. Why? Because we expect to see the price higher. So attacking here would mean you're exposed to this move before an actual move to the downside side comes. Hence the less risk. Okay? So I think that's how we can summarize it. In the short term, we can expect the price to continue slightly higher. We have an option to go aggressive to medium with the first attempt, or if it pushes upwards, we're going to continue following for the next setup to form approximately around the 38 to 50 of this entire move. And the final targets, if you decide to go ahead and short, of course, and use this setup, the final target would be approximately towards the bottom of this range, the extreme point. Okay, so that would be all, guys. If you have any questions, please leave your comments below. If you're interested in another pair or any other asset, and I have some interesting to share with you, of course, I'll be happy to create a video. So leave your comments below with the pairs or assets, other instruments that you'd like to see me discussing, and I'll go ahead and create my video and do my best to answer your questions. Wishing you a wonderful week. That would be all for now. Bye.